Welcome to my channel. Let's now write a program for matrix multiplication. I have chosen this program because it involves three loops. Let's quickly see how to multiply two matrices. Let's take the numbers 2, 3, 5, 4, 1, 6 and multiply it with another matrix 2, 1, 3, 4, 1, 8. Say this is matrix A and this is matrix B and we are going to multiply it. First, you have to take the first row of matrix A and multiply that with the first column of matrix B. You should multiply 2 with 2 and then 3 with 3 and then 5 with 1 and then add the results. So it is 2 into 2 plus 3 into 3 plus 5 into 1. So when you compute this expression, you will have the first element of the resultant array, which is C. Now let the first row be here as such, but let's take the second column in matrix B instead of first. Again, you have to do the same corresponding multiplication and then addition. So it's 2 into 1 plus 3 into 4 plus 5 into 8. Now we have done with the first row, you have to move to the second row. Multiply the second row with the first column. 4 into 2 plus 1 into 3 plus 6 into 1. And now move to the second column here. So this is the resultant matrix. Here A is a 2 cross 3 matrix because it has 2 rows and 3 columns. Similarly, B is 3 cross 2 matrix because it has 3 rows and 2 columns. You can see that C is a 2 cross 2 matrix. Whenever you are multiplying, you are taking one row at a time from matrix A and one column at a time from matrix B. When you are taking one row at a time, you are moving through the columns here. Similarly, here you are traveling through the rows. Since you have to multiply the corresponding elements and add, the number of columns in the first matrix should match the number of rows in the second matrix. Only then it is possible to multiply the two matrices. Otherwise, you cannot multiply the matrices at all. Let's say M and N denotes the number of rows and columns of matrix A. Similarly, P and Q denotes the number of rows and columns of matrix B. So the condition here is that N should be equal to P. If N is not equal to P, it is impossible to multiply those two matrices. Now let's write the program. First, we have to scan matrix A, that is, get the input elements of matrix A. So first, we should ask for the user to enter the number of rows and columns and scan M and N, which we can do very easily. And then we have to get the elements of the first matrix. As it is a two-dimensional array, this denotes the 0, 0 element, this is 0, 1 and this is 0, 2. Here the 0 represents the row and 0, 1, 2 represents the columns. Similarly, this is 1, 0, 1, 1 and 1, 2. So in order to scan these elements, you need two loops for I equal to 0, I less than the number of rows, which is M, I plus plus. And J is for traveling through the column, so J less than N, J plus plus. And you have to get the input value from the user and store it in the array. The position is I, J. So by doing so, you will be able to scan all the elements of the first matrix. Similarly, you have to change the logic for scanning the second matrix by changing M to P and N to Q and here A to B. Now that we have scanned the two matrices, let's get to the main logic. So let's generalize what we are doing. First, we are taking one row at a time from matrix A. And for each of those rows, we have to multiply by taking one column at a time from matrix B. First, we are taking one row at a time from matrix A. For each of those rows, we are multiplying with all the columns in matrix B. So the outermost loop should be able to loop through all the rows in matrix A for I equal to starting with the 0th row and you have to scan all the rows in matrix A. The total number of rows in matrix A is M. So I less than m, I plus plus. Now for each of the row, you have to multiply with each column in matrix B. The first row should be multiplied with first and then second column, and then the second row should be multiplied with first and second column. So that is why we are going to write a loop within a loop. Now this loop should be able to travel through the columns in matrix B. So it's for j equal to 0. The number of columns in matrix B is q. So j less than q, j plus plus. As I mentioned in the beginning, this program requires three loops. So why do you need the third loop for? Is it for finding the position of the resultant element? Let's see. This is the 0, 0 element of the result. It is found by multiplying the 0th row of A and 0th column of B. This is the element 0, 1. It is found by multiplying the 0th row of A with the first column of B. Similarly, this is 1, 0, which is found by multiplying the first row of A with the 0th column. And this is 1, 1, which is got by multiplying the first row of A with the first column of B. So the index of the result is very easy to find. It is just C of I, J. You don't need a third variable for that. But in order to find C of ij, we need to multiply the corresponding elements, right? Here, I refers to the row of A. And similarly, j here refers to the column of B. But in order to access each of these elements, you need to know both the row and column number of A. Same applies to accessing the elements of B. So you have got the row number with the help of I. In order to find the column of A, k equal to 0, k less than, we are talking about column of A, right? Which means we have to proceed until n, k plus plus. But we also have to access the elements of B. Here with j, we only know the column of B. What about the rows of B? The rows of B should start from 0 until P. Since N and P are equal, we can use this same variable for the column of A and row of B. Let's write the code, you will understand it better. C of ij is nothing but, in order to access the element of A, we know that it is A of I, and the column can be found with the help of K into B of. The row of B can be again found with the help of K and the column using J. Here, this helps us to only multiply one of the elements. We have to accumulate the product. While calculating the second product, we have to add it to the previous result. We can use the shorthand operator here, but you have to make sure that C of ij is initialized every time. We have to initialize it here. Here, instead of n, you can also use p because n is equal to p. I will leave the link for the complete program in the description box below. Thank you for listening.